Property tax, education, and health care changes will affect Oskaloosa residents as a result of laws passed by the Iowa legislature this session. The legislature adjourned more than a week ago, but not before finding compromise on those three main issues. CRI's Eduardo Zamarripa met with Oskaloosa State Representative Guy Vander Linden for details.
Thank you so much, Mr. Vander Linden, for meeting with us today. The legislature tackled three main issues before adjourning last week: education reform, property tax reform, and health care reform. So we kind of wanted to get started by talking about property tax reform.
Okay.
We've heard that people are calling it the biggest property tax reform in Iowa in years or in history.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about what kind of changes are being made and how that impacts an average property tax owner?
Okay. Well, the three issues that you mentioned, and you're right, they were probably the biggest issues that we addressed in the session, and they all came at the end, and they were all compromises. The property tax bill that we passed was not as generous as what I would have preferred, but it is property tax relief, and the major things it does are make it so that if you own a commercial property, eventually, over a period of a couple of years, instead of paying property tax on the full 100% value of your business, you'll only pay 90%. More important than that, in my mind, is the fact that residential property tax can only go up at a rate of 3% a year under the new program, as opposed to 4%. That was a compromise. The House wanted 2, the Senate wanted to keep it at 4, we ended up at 3. But it is tax relief. And the important thing to me is that we finally passed some sort of property tax relief, particularly for commercial interests, without raising residential property tax. And that will make Iowa more competitive with neighboring states in terms of attracting new business, getting people to start businesses in Iowa, and it, I think, will be a contribution to the economy of Iowa.
The Iowa health care plan is something that the legislature agreed to move on with. Would you mind explaining what's the biggest difference between the proposed Medicaid expansion by the federal government and the Iowa Healthy Plan that is being that was passed by the Iowa legislature?
Well, the biggest difference is that beneficiaries of the plan will have to, for the most part, will have to contribute to their health insurance just like the rest of us. The original plan, the Medicaid expansion, so-called Medicaid expansion, would have been a free benefit to individuals. Some people at the bottom of the economic scale will still get that, but those who can pay will have to pay, just like the rest of us. So again, it's a compromise. The Healthy Iowa plan isn't perfect, but it's better than just expanding Medicaid, which is, in my mind, pretty much a failed program across the nation.
The other big ticket item that was tackled was education reform, mm-hmm. which had been in the works for a couple years now. You're giving 4% allowable growth for schools for the next 2 years. How did that agreement come about? Are you providing 4% for the first year, and then for the second year it's 2% and a one-time 2% payment?
That's close. It's actually 2 + 2 in the first year, and then 4% in fiscal year 2015. Again, that's a compromise. The Senate started out saying we want 4% for both years, and the House said 2. When it went to conference committee, after some discussion amongst House Republicans, we agreed to offer to go to 4 for both years, or 2 + 2 and 4, if we could get certain reforms that were in the policy part of the package. After a great deal of deliberation on the part of the Senate conferees, we finally pretty much came to that. The original education reform package came from the governor. It was modified substantially, which is no surprise in the legislative process. Probably the biggest thing in policy that I think came out of it was the fact that where there's going to be some accountability for teachers. Their in essence, efficiency reports are going to be based on production. And I think that's a step in the right direction. It also does some great things to attract people to the teaching profession, including a raise in salary, minimum salary for starting teachers, and an opportunity to grow throughout their careers, which I think will attract, we're hopeful that it will attract qualified, really outstanding teachers to the profession.
Well, thank you very much for taking the time to explain the highlights of the legislative session that adjourned, and we really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thanks for asking me. Good to see you.
Allowable growth is the amount of funding schools receive from the state. For the upcoming school year, Iowa schools will receive 2% allowable growth plus a one-time payment that is equivalent to 2%. Then, for the 2014-2015 school year, schools will receive 4% allowable growth. Visit our website, CRITV.org, and click on the Guy Vander Linden article to find more information on property tax, education, and health care reform.